Hey guys, Vikas over here and you are watching Virginius. Guys, today I am again with a new video around OpenApp. We'll see how to install OpenApp 2 onto Linux. And over here I am using Ubuntu 16.04 Server Edition. I tried with apt-get method but that didn't work for me, so I went with the manual installation method. So over here we'll see how to install OpenApp 2 onto Linux, or specifically Ubuntu 16.04. Again, the Ubuntu 16.04 doesn't come with any Java installation, so we need to manually install Java, which I have covered in my previous video. So if you are using the server edition, make sure to check my earlier video, which is linked down below in the description. Being said that, let's get started, guys. So guys, to start with this, over here I am having an SSH connection to my server, and I'll first be copying this link over here from bintray.com, which provides us the OpenApp builds. Again, over here I am installing OpenApp 2 manually to my server. Actually, the apt-get method I tried, but that didn't work for me. So just copy this link over here, and you can use the command wget. Link and hit enter, and it may take some time, and that is actually 65 MB of file, so just wait for it till it get completed. And one more thing, if your server doesn't have any Java installation, please check my earlier tutorial to install Zulu JDK onto your server. Again, you can go with Oracle, but Zulu JDK is being recommended by OpenApp. Now, after the download completes, let's unzip the downloaded file. To do that, I'll use sudo unzip, then the file name, and the destination is, I'll rename it OpenApp 2. And again, you might not be having unzip installed, so make sure to install unzip before running this command. Now let's see if you have successfully extracted. Over here, find a directory like OpenApp 2. Now let's remove the downloaded file. Let's get into OpenApp 2. And you'll have different folders like over here. Now the add-ons and all. If you are interested in installing the add-on that comes with OpenApp 2, then you can directly download from the Bintray website and copy that to the add-ons folder, which is over here. Just download this into the add-ons folder. Let's clear it. Yep. Now we need to create a user for OpenApp, and over here we are adding an user to the system with, like, we don't want to create the home folder for it, and the login is disabled for it. Yep. So actually I have already tried it, so it is saying OpenApp already exists. Now we need to change the permission for the OpenApp 2 folder, and we are going to make OpenApp as the owner of the folder. And for that I'll use the command sudo chown minus chown OpenApp, then the folder name. That's done. Now, after changing the permissions of the owner, let's run the script file that will run the OpenApp server. It might take some time when you are running for the first time, and it will open up the OpenApp that is JT server on port 8080. So, on your browser, navigate to the IP address of your server with the port number 8080. Yeah, this is not yet come up, so let's wait for a couple of minutes. Again, if you are running this for the first time, it might take some time. Yep, the server is come up, but so yeah, you can see over here. Now select what UI you want. So I'll go with the recommended one, the standard one, and again it may take some time. So now as the OpenApp 2 is up and running, you might be interested it to run automatically whenever your server boots up. And to do that, we need to create a service. And again, I'll not be describing all that in this video. So I'll just put that in my blog post. So make sure to check that out, which is linked down below in the description.
Yep, the UI has come up, and again, you can get it Pepper UI and do all the usual stuff that can be done with any installation.
So again, I'll not go with the details like what is forward or like how to use all those UIs and all. So make sure to check my earlier videos where I have described which UI is used for what and all. So guys, thanks for watching, and I hope you have enjoyed this video. If so, hit the thumbs up button, and if you have not subscribed yet, consider subscribing my channel. So see you next time with my next video. Till then, goodbye.